Howdy guys, OniLink here, welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade X, where last time we took on a few missions in the Rothian Stronghold, and we fought a few tyrants. Today, we're right next to FN Site 505, and... Hello, Zazazan! Are you sure you're not actually Zazadon? Come in from another game entirely. Ah, some bodyguard friend is. Where's weapon? My weapon? It got totaled by some monsters on my way out here from NLA. Better it than me, though, am I right? Anyway, what's the big deal? You get me a new piece, I'll keep you safe. Just like your contract says. I'll just be waiting right here until you get it all worked out, okay, Fuzzy? Why is Zazazan running errands for Harvey when Zazazan is boss? Friend is Blade, too, yes? Are you all Blades so bad? This one is useless. Harvey, it's your weapon. You should be taking care of it, and also have one. Damn, brother, that's saying. Then again, I bet most folks don't meet your exacting standards. Most folks die if they don't meet my so-called standards. Zazazan should have asked someone who liked reliable blade friend in the first place. Still, contract is signed, so Zazazan is stuck with lazy bodyguard. Ah, you really know how to make a guy feel special. Look, this ain't that hard. You find me a weapon, I'll risk my neck to keep yours intact. Fine, you're there. Responsible blade friend. Go find weapon for Harvey so we can do job and defend Zazazan. Please. Zazazan is in hurry to deliver inventory to NLA. Okay, we need an iron sword, a warrior assault rifle, and a titanium shield. Zazazan is glad that friend is so reasonable. Now, please go fetch random weapon. Whoa, whoa, it's an iron sword or bust with me, pal. Personal policy, no exceptions. Oh, and my buddies will be needing a warrior assault rifle and a titanium shield. Thanks, in junk, yeah? Ah, this tomfoolery frost cookies of Zazazan. But there's probably no use in arguing. Sorry, friend. Well, let's go get some equipment. I'll be right back. Alright, Zazazan, I got you your equipment. Meh, quit touching merchandise, Harvey. That inventory, very important. Haha, whoops, you got it, boss. So, what exactly are we shipping here? That is nothing Harvey need to worry about. Just do what Zazazan pay you to do and keep it safe. Ah, responsible friend is back. And the weapons? If friend has them, please hand them over. First was iron sword. Next was warrior assault rifle. Third was titanium shield. Oh, that's me talking! What?! Good, is Harvey happy now? Looks just fine to me, should be more than enough to keep you and your stock safe, boss. Zazazan wonder. What does friend think? Does Harvey seem capable of protecting Zazazan? Honestly, no. Zazazan agree with Harvey as bodyguard, we may not make it through Silverlum in one piece. Zazazan should have hired you instead, friend. In any case, thank you. Please take this. Alright, the bodyguard is clear. Heh, you two all done over there? Yes, now we can leave, and maybe Harvey will learn a thing or two from hardworking friend here. Will do, boss. Now that I've got a weapon, ain't nothing out there that can stand in my way. Time to hit the road for a home sweet home. Next up, NLA. Alright, and on to the next mission. Our next mission is at the Cauldron's Gate from, once again, Zazazan. Hey, you okay? You look dead. You didn't even make it into Silverlum. Jeez! Harvey must have really done a number. I get the feeling Harvey stole the equipment is what I'm getting at. He seemed very suspicious. Is that you? Zazazan played dead, fooled Harvey like charm. Scum started shooting Zazazan in bags and took off with Nopopotamus and entire inventory. Figured. Please, friend must help Zazazan get goods back. If contents of shipment used for evil purposes, results could be terrible. Well, where were they going? Actually, I need both of this information. I need to know what they're doing with it, but more importantly, I need to know where they are. Friend aims to fight them. Very impressive. Humans all seem to be a terrible bunch, but friend is clearly different. Seems like Harvey headed for cave up ahead. Not too long has passed, so friend should be able to catch up and give them sound thrashing. Alright, let's go hunt down Harvey in the Den of the Dead. Zazazan overcome with gratitude. Remember, though, Harvey and others are armed with weapons friend brought them. Be careful. Well, thankfully, those were, like, the weakest weapons around, so... Alright, off we go to track down Harvey. Well, on my way up there, I found a helicopter up above North Island Sea Base Camp. We got Mining Probe G6, very good. Alright, looks like our destination is right by FN Site 416. Right here. Hello, Den of the Dead. Now, where are you, Harvey? Let's try up this way. Alright, looks like he's up here. Take a left. And another left through a small passage. I can't get my scale in there. Alright. Here we go. Hi there, Harvey. Easy there, girl. Easy. Heh, this big dumb lunk loves us. I told you feeding it treats before making our move would pay off. Now, who's ready to unwrap the presents? Heh, old Zazazan was real protective of this here shipment. If it pans out, we may not need to work for weeks. Hey, assholes. What the? He's got a lock on it? Oh, for the love of... Look around, idiot. Somebody find a rock or something we can use to smash it open. Huh? Hey, you're that guy. Let me guess. Zazazan hired you to steal stuff back, right? That guy's cheaper than a Scrooge, so if he's willing to spend that much on a shipment, it's gotta be... What? Rare jewels? Rare weapons? Whatever it is, I can't wait. And we'll have all the time in the world to check it out once we're done with you. One last job, boys. Time to show this punk not to stick his nose in our business. You realize you're dealing with literally three of the top people of Blade and a new recruit, right? Like, we're the ones who saved the Lifehold. You're fucked. Only level 18? Jeez! You guys are pathetic. This is gonna be fun. Oh, hey! I'm at class level 10. When'd that happen? Oh my god, I'm doing nothing to them. No, 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 no! Don't hurt the... Don't kill the Nopopotamus! Oh, no.
Move in and keep the rhythm going. Cut to the lake. Huh. Shadow strike. Oh,
come on.
Seriously, how are we doing nothing to these guys? I mean, they're doing even less to us, but still. Here we go. Bam! One down. Harvey, you're next. Alright, I almost got him. God damn it, how do you guys take so long to kill? Okay, one more Blade Trooper, and then we can get the Nopopotamus. I feel bad for the Nopopotamus, it did nothing wrong. Oh, Nopopotamus is down. Good job, guys. We got Zazazan's package. Very good. Alright, back to Zazazan. Hey there, Zazazan. Good news, we got your package back. Bad news, someone, I won't say who, Mia, probably Lynn actually, killed your Nopopotamus. Zazazan is glad to see your friend back safe. So then, what if she's the shipment? I got it. Oh ho ho! Zazazan saved! If that shipment was lost, Zazazan would have been ruined. Oh, and the Nopopotamus? Well, it attacked us, so... Killed, as in dead? Well, no helping it now, but Zazazan not able to carry this much by himself. Is there a chance Friend could bring it back to New L.A.? These goods are extremely important, but Zazazan trusts Friend. Whatever happens, do not peek inside. Friend is clear on this. Absolutely no peeking. None. Meh. Also, a flunky of elder named Loma asks about shipment, just dodge the question. Loma is the same as Harvey. So sneaky. Aims to take goods of Zazazan for himself. Alright, got it. Friend is a kind, sparkly, useful human. Nothing like jerk-faced Harvey. Many thanks, Friend. Deliver shipment to Bodada at Napon Bazaar in New LA and the job is finished. Alright, off to NLA. I looked up what the answers to this quest are because I was very curious about what was going to happen. And turns out my joke about it being Zazadon? Not too inaccurate. Hey, Loma! I knew he should be suspicious of him. Where is he? Always sneaking around and skittering off when Loma catch him in sights. Pardon, has Friend seen Napon here named Bodada? I have not seen him. Loma see. Well, a Friend does see him. Please let Loma know. Loma? I have a package for you. Hold on, let's try the other option then. Tell me more about Bodada. Bodada going around selling red pollen orbs to everyone he sees at a serious pain in fuzzy butt. Eating orbs gives huge spike of energy, but on come down it makes the user very lazy. Then they not work and caravan suffers. Bad news for everyone. If Loma not catch Bodada, problem will spread. Too many Napon lured him by promise of instant energy boost, only to become useless lump. So, I have something for you. What? Loma knew those two were connected. And Friend here is carrying shipment for them. Will Friend let Loma take a look? Of course. What? Show it to Loma. If it contains red pollen orbs, that is proof Loma need to bring Bodada down. I am so glad I didn't trust Zazazan and went on to double check. Such color, such shine. Now Loma analyzed composition. So red, one bite and zoom, but then crash. Yep, this is red pollen orb. Alright. Loma appreciate cooperation of Friend. This should be enough to bring in lowlifes. Loma will hurry and catch Bodada before he has chance to flee. Loma managed to catch lowlifes just as they meet up. Two villains for price of one. Friend betrayed Zazazan? Friend is just as awful as Harvey. Zazazan done with humans for good. This human is at life just as awful ones are Zazazan and Bodada for profiting off of red pollen orbs. Once Loma report you to elders, Zazazan and Bodada never do business here again. No, not that. Please, anything with that, if Bodada unable to make money, life loses all purpose. And special delivery done. And in two games now, we have ruined the drug trade. NLA Auto Parks. Alright, on to some tyrants. Well, I found the tyrants we needed to kill, but it's not coming out of the ground. Oh, never mind. Hello, Atreides the Distinguished. Actually, you're not who I need to kill, but if we kill you, good things will happen.
I won't let you down. So long,
Shadow. Ow. Rude. I need to get some Tobble Resist augments, because they keep knocking me out.
Avatar
missile! You know, I'm gonna do exactly that. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get some augment for my skill. So it turns out, I don't even have the blueprints for resist topple, and resist launch is expensive. So I instead made a bunch of, ether reflect and resist physical reflect augment. So that with 100% each. And it turns out they are very cheap. Perforated ores are needed for the ether reflect, which is what was killing me earlier. Because this guy has reflect ether on him, so my attack was hitting me in the face and killing me. But the reflect ether only takes 5 perforated ores for 100%, and those drop from level 1 Terebra, so on to the next tyrant. Next up, we are back in Silvalum, and we got this tyrant over here to fight in Lake Seal. Oh boy, it's got friends. There we go. Oh man, that didn't take it down? Okay then, putting up a fight, I see. It won't last long. Oh boy, hang in there, Urbans. Oh boy, it's just me now. Holy crap! Lorenzo, you're tough! Okay, I need that resist launch, but too bad it's so expensive. Okay, I'm out of here. On the other side of Lake Seal, during Crimson Auroras, this guy turns into a tyrant, Ignite the Ultimate Chaos. I have a bad feeling about this. Oh boy.
I won't miss this chance.
Well, so far, we're doing pretty well. Hasn't done too much to us. Damage seems manageable. Oh boy. Yeah, this seems manageable. Well, we already lost one skill. And the other one's about to go. What? Wait, what? Oh boy. Okay, Silvalum's too tough for me. I'm out of here. Fine, if the tyrants are too tough for me, I'll just kill this random stray Potamus over here. And that gives us a sapphire ring. Well, that looks important. Let's see where it goes. Well, if you go up to the cleansing spring to the Silvalum caravan during the day, past 7 a.m., Neo's here. Over the top wedding dresses in the shop are the best. Neo just have to get one for Popo. And where in the heck is Natoto? Neo does not have cash on hand to buy dress. What should Neo do? Neo is merchant too, right? Yes? The Neo knows never to waffle on major purchase. If Neo has found perfect dress, stop thinking and make with buying. Especially for dresses popular as this one. If friend keep hemming and hawing, Nana will sell out. No! There's nothing else for it. Sorry, human friend. Neo promises not scam. Neo respectable business opon will shop at Caravan and Caldros. Perhaps friend knows of Neo necessities? So, can friend spot Neo some cash? Neo swear to pay it all back. How much do you need? Oh, really? Neo never expects that to work. Friend is awfully nice. If a total stranger asked Neo for loan, Neo would set new land speed record running away. But yes, please listen to the story of Neo. Ahem. So once upon a time, which is actually very soon, Neo will marry super cute girl named Popo. Neo really want to purchase gorgeous wedding dress sold here as a gift for lovely bride. But an opon named Toto is that his bringing wedding ring and all assets of Neo still not turned up. So please lend Neo 20,000 credits so he can buy dress. Popo is daughter of wealthy tycoon. If Neo not give her a nice gown, in-laws will think Neo is worthless. I understand. I will give you 20,000 credits and it looks like you're going to pay me back at the end. Come back and talk to Neo once friend has some money together. No need to worry, as soon as Toto arrived, Neo can pay friend back. Alright, here's your cash. Sweet smell of cash. Does friend have the 20,000 credits? Yes, I do. Okay, Neo borrowing you exactly 20,000 credits, sign on dotted line of IOU, and here, friend should hold on to this. Oh, an IOU. Now it's official. Now you have to pay me back. Contracts are absolute to Nappa. Nappa to break contract, get kicked out of caravan. Very serious, end of life as merchant. So rest easy, friend just needs to wait until Ntoto arrives with money. Alright. I trust you. Neo is glad friend believes. When Ntoto arrive with cash, Neo treat a friend a tasty meal as extra thanks. Now then, Neo will take one extremely over-the-top dress, please. How about this one? Nana let Neo have it a special price in honor of wedding. Gah! That's way too much! Price is off by at least 2 digits! Meh! If Nappon marrying one and only Popo and is unable to handle price like this, then that Nappon better call whole thing off now. Hobby Pond, like Patty will get dumped before year is out. Meh! Neo not petty! Neo not even like pets! Just wait 1 minute! Neo Neo have no choice. Neo must go borrow money from Jololo. Would human friend come serve as witness? Alright, I can help out! You're in a bit of a pickle, aren't you? Where'd you go? Oh, over here!
Guess what?
Meh! Why should Jololo lend someone else money to buy a present for Popo? Mm-hmm. Human has business with moneylender Jololo. Jololo willing to lend, but interest are at 100% every 10 days. What? That's bullshit! Jololo not need to answer that, but he will anyway. Worm sitting next to human friend is reason. Miro will freeze over before Jololo would lend to. Wait, no, this is perfect. Alright, Jololo changed mind. Jololo will take pity and lend money to Neo. Really? Then Neo eager to sign. But if Neo failed to pay entire sum back by specified dates, Jololo will take every last piece of stringy hair on head of Neo in lieu of payment. What? But Tuft is pride of any Nappon. Neo could never part with it. Then no deal. Neo will have no present for young miss and failed wedding will most shameful event of year. Well, as soon as Ntoto arrive, Neo can pay back loans, so alright, Neo will sign contract. You're putting a lot of faith in Ntoto showing up. You might want to double think of this, because, according to you, he's missing. He should have been here by now. Not to worry, money Neo has saved can cover this, no problem. Okay, here's a signed contract, and if due date comes and Neo unable to pay, Jololo can have all this lovely, lovely tuft hair. Yes, pleasure doing business. Just make sure you come back with the money, worm. Oh-ho, now Popo can have perfect wedding dress she deserve. Neo must hurry before they sell out. Was Neo here just now? Popo is fiancé pawn of Neo and have urgent news for him. Let's not spoil the surprise. Why would Neo borrow money from Jololo? Ntoto not no reason, but Neo must have thought to pay it back with money Ntoto was bringing. Okay, Ntoto did show up, but what is this urgent news? We must stop that fool Nappon! What happened? I am very worried now. Ah, nice money lending friend. Kind friend came by to check up on Neo. Well, Neo got price gouged but bought dress anyway. Neo hoped to make a surprise present of it, but Popo found out. Now Neo feeling all blushy. This is no time for blushing. Every last asset of Neo just got lost. What? But Ntoto packed it all in Nappopotamus and bring it here along with Ring, right? Well, during trip, Ntoto was resting Nopopotamus, but Lakeside, I might have dozed off, just for a quick nap. When Ntoto wake up, Nopopotamus had been killed. Cargo must have been carried off by Karo or the like. Ntoto had tied ring to teeth of Nopopotamus, but that was also gone. But forget that for 1 minute. Is it true Neo borrowed money from Crook Jalolo? Yes, also from human friend here. Okay, seriously, don't worry about it. I have plenty of money from Frontier Nav. I will help you figure out what happened and get your money back. This is not cool. What terrible luck. Meh. Neo worked so hard saving up money for this day. Meh. Jalolo, hear everything. Oh, this is rich. Take a close look at loan agreement. If signee is unable to pay in cash, every hair on head must be plucked down and handed over immediately. What? Tuft on head is pride of Nopon. Only lowest of low would take that away. Young Miss talks of Nopon pride, but this one here signed contract. As thought upon a merchant, Popo understands what that means. Breaking contract means banishment from caravan and banning from trade with other Nopon. Meh. Jalolo perfectly happy either way. Neo can spend from now until due date deciding how he wants to settle up. Neo, sorry. So sorry. Neo just wants so bad for Popo to have beautiful dress. Silly Nopon, Popo not need fancy dress. All Popo need to be as happy as Neo. But no use dwelling on that now. Contract looks scary legitimate. If Neo unable to pay, Neo will be at mercy of Jalolo. Ah. You know, I could probably lend you some money. Some more money. I don't care how long it takes as long as you pay me back eventually because I understand you're in a bit of a shit situation right now. Friend is generous, but contract specifically requires it to be money of Neo. Jalolo lent Neo that money hoping for this outcome. He is evil, evil Nopon. There must be some other way, some angle. Ah! Neo, Popo struck with brilliant plan. No, Neo should give Tuft to Jalolo. What kind of plan is that? Popo said herself that Tuft is pride of Nopon. Besides, family of Popo would never allow her to marry bald Nopon. Hehe, which is why Neo make fake Tuft to give Jalolo instead. Contract clearly stated that payment had to come from money of Neo. But it never said hair had to be real hair of Neo. That is brilliant. And given that the fake baby trick worked. Watching friends struggle for solution was inspiration for Popo. Thank you. So, now that plan is decided, next step is to gather materials. Would friend be willing to help? For ingredients, Popo will need dire sheep, and also anthurus roses. We will all protect Tuff and Neo together. I think I have all that. Meh. Jalolo came by again to gloat. That guy makes stomach and poor Neo ache. Has friend found materials for fake Tuft? Neo really need those before loan comes due. Here you go. 10 collectibles. Uncanny, this feels exactly like hair of Neo. And Popo can make hairpiece out of this? Popo will have Tuft wig ready in no time. Neo can wear it and we'll go see Jalolo together. Alright, would you come too? Neo want friend to be there for this. Of course. Friend and Popo are both too kind. With help of you two, Neo feel able to handle anything that comes. Alright, Jalolo. Get wrecked. With a fake tuft of hair. Ah, here comes Worm, all ready to be smushed by mighty Jalolo. Well, Worm, what will it be? Payback money or cut off hair? Or maybe Worm will break contract and choose exile from Nopon society. Choose how Jalolo will be entertained today. Neo was unable to get the money. Jalolo can have Tuft. Meh, did Jalolo see you cut it off here and now? Jalolo want to see the beginning of humiliating life for Neo as bald Nopon. Popo will cut, Jalolo should watch close to see what this foolish contract has earned. Ready for Popo to begin, Neo? Neo would let beautiful Popo do anything. No need to hold back. Meh! So shameful, much humiliating. Young Miss can't possibly marry Nopon who looked like that. Popo deserved wealthy Nopon with thick head of hair, so why not marry Chololo instead? You're kind of disgusting. Chololo never signed contract forbidding laughter. Besides, how does friend expect Chololo not to laugh at sight like this? Meh! Thank you, friend, but Neo not mind. Neo has someone who loves him even like this. Others can laugh as long as Neo has Popo. Such a loathsome pair. Fine. Contract is complete and enjoy life of shame and ridicule, Baldy. And there he goes. Toto thinks this plan is huge success. Woohoo! Chololo had no clue hair was fake. Whew, now we can finally have wedding. But Neo still lost everything. Business will have to be built back up from scratch. Is Popo really sure she wants this? Oh, forget money. What Popo wants is Neo. Though shame Popo won't get to wear a ring picked out by Neo. Neo's so lucky, and Neo worked really hard to save up money and buy another blue sparkly ring. Blue sparkly ring, huh? Hey, I think I found something for you.
Thank you.
Oh, Popo still need to thank friend. Friend has something for Popo. Oh, so blue, so sparkly. Wait, is this? It is wedding ring Neo bought. Oh, this is like wonderful dream. Hey, wait 1 minute, that ring was stolen. How does friend have it? It was in a, No, it wasn't an hippopotamus. It was, What was it? What was it I fought? Wow, I'm forgetful. Wait, friend mistook that hippopotamus for wild one and killed it while Ntoto was napping? Ntoto was terrified when nap ended. Well, with hippopotamus suddenly being corpse and all. Then the one who caused all this trouble in first place is human friend? Ugh, and all this time Neo was stressing out enough to go bald. But Ring found its way back to Neo, so it all worked out. Besides, this only happened because Neo took out crazy loan for sake of Popo. So never do that again. This ring is more than enough for Popo. Okay, Neo promised to be himself and stop worrying about material things. From now on, Neo will focus only on keeping Popo safe and happy. This turned into a very weird adventure, but please take this as thanks for all friend has done. It was a stray potamus. That's what it was, but I thought Nopopotamus were really big potamuses, but the thing I fought was tiny. Well, segment clear. And let's finish this off by heading back to NLA real quick. Alright, I think this affinity shift should hopefully finally be ready. Well, fiddle-dee-dee, I can't remember the last time anyone other than a salesman called on me. May I ask you something? Lately I've had an Nopon salesman knocking on my door one after the other. They're always trying to sell me their handmade junk at absurdly inflated prices. Drum twirls made of woven leaves, acorn abacuses, that sort of thing. They look so cute and yet there's something so sleazy about them. I worry that they're hunting for weak-minded people who buy whatever junk they're pushing. I'd like to file a complaint before someone gets canned, but I don't know who to talk to about it. I hear that Nopon Elder is bad news in all sorts of ways, so he's out, but who else is there? You know what? Loma. Loma seems pretty good at weeding out bad Nopon. So?
Amazing.
So this Loma patrols the streets, cracking down on evildoers? I had no idea the Nopon could be so righteous. Very well, I shall go file a complaint with Loma. At the very least, I hope that will stop the salesman from visiting me 20 to 30 times a day, trying every possible strategy to sell me their junk. I swear, I've had it with him. Alright, segment clear, putting us up to 95% in the residential district. Now, let's finish the episode with a Collectopedia update, finally! First time in quite a while! But we should be- oh my god, how are we not done yet? Well, let's put what we have in. 95% there, 100% in Noctilum. Oblivia, how are you doing? You're almost there. Let's just go ahead and fill everything up. How are we not done yet? Oh my god. What are we missing? Okay, Silvalum's next. Oh my god, we have so many dire sheep. Here we go, row complete. Another row complete. Almost there, just need, what, one more? Yeah, one more for Silvalum and we'll be good. Alright, Caldros, how are you doing? Row complete. And a category complete. Wait, that's in... Wait. Does that mean we have every vegetable? Oh, we do! We have every vegetable! Very nice. Alright, Flora. Alright, Lucky Panel gives us battle points. Oh my god, we have a lot of battle points. I have to start spending those. Row complete. Category complete. We have every single, Flora now. Row complete. And category complete. Well, the good news is we are almost done with the Collectopedia. Oh, wow, all the relics. All right, Curios are up next. And it looks like that's all we have for now. Let's see, how many more collectibles do we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's only 9 types left that we need to get. Alright, Collectopedia is almost done. Okay, next time on Let's Play Xenoblade X, what do you say we go take on the second to last Affinity mission in the game? Take on the second to last quest in the game, and then see what we can do to finish off the commercial district. There is a quest over here that you've probably seen a few times behind the cathedral. Yeah. We are saving this one for last. This will be the very last quest we do. Alright then, I will see you guys next time for the second to last Affinity mission.